There we go.
Great gun, baby.
What's the question of the day? I forgot the
What's one thing that's broken around your house you have yet to fix? Good, gotta go. Turn it down, or we're gonna get shut down by Facebook. Good morning, everybody. Open this bad boy up. Okay. 46 seconds. New Hanover sweatshirt.
Nice.
Now Megan can go back to school. I got my swag, so I'm ready to go. I'm going to turn this
down. Oh, one quick announcement. I was told yesterday, I never realized how low this camera went. And I have a habit of adjusting my shirt, tucking it in through my pants by pulling it down. And I was told that didn't look so good. So I'm not going to do that anymore.
Don't let them keep you down, man. Don't let them keep you down. You want to adjust yourself on Facebook Live? You go right ahead, sir. All right. Let's go have some fun.
Now, back to the Wake Up Call with Phil Quinn. Brought to you by Phillips Drugs on Richmond's Classic Hits.
38 degrees here in the Whitewater Valley, 642. Thank you for being a part of the Wake Up Call. Thanks to all those folks listening and watching on Facebook Live. How are you? I just gave the okay sign. Oh, my God. You're not supposed to do the okay sign. I was okay. I can't do it because now it means something. It means something racial. White supremacists have taken away my ability to give the okay sign. I just waved. Now I can't do that. I don't know what I don't know what I was thinking, and it just happened.
Welcome to 2019, Phil Quinn.
All right. Yesterday we had sensitive, very kind of scary situation happening with a silver alert, and just either right after the show ended at 9 o'clock, or there was an update, and so now we have everybody's safe at this point.
Yeah, it was at around 9 o'clock yesterday when Summer Lee, who was the alleged victim in all this, was able to get to a home and call for help, and because they were involved in a car crash, and when I say they, I mean her husband, 38-year-old Travis Lee, who is the suspect in all of this. They had actually crashed on Sunday night, so they had no real means of getting very far. When Summer Lee got to this home, she was able to let authorities know that Travis Lee was likely still in the area. That prompted another large manhunt yesterday morning, and it didn't last long. They were able to track him down and take him into custody after a short foot chase. Mm. Now, he's still in jail this morning, and he faces a whole lot more very serious charges. The heist is a level 2 felony, so he's not likely going to go anywhere anytime soon. Now, remember that last week we had told you that he was charged with a bunch of felonies in Randolph County after allegedly choking her to the point of unconsciousness. So, Travis Lee, I think his days are numbered they're done now for at least a while.
Right.
If he is convicted. Let's turn now to the other big story from yesterday. That is the felony charging of the Dennis Intermediate School shooter's mother. She now faces 6 felonies in connection with events that led up to that incident last December.
Okay, so it's weird that this came out now. What, without offering too much conjecture, I think it had something to do with her appearance on Dr. Oz.
Well, I guess a lot of people could draw that conclusion because there's nothing really that has been alleged by prosecutors that couldn't have been alleged months ago. But again, we don't know all the inside workings of the case, but we do know that she did appear. That episode of Dr. Oz did air last month, and certainly it could be interpreted that way. But some of the details that are in the affidavit are just unbelievable. And keep in mind now that she had said repeatedly that she didn't really see any signs of what was coming. And remember, right after the incident, she was actually labeled a hero for calling authorities and letting people know that he was coming, which I guess in one sense that's
sure.
Still true.
Sure.
But prosecutors say that she was aware of her son's mental health issues for months. Not only that, but that she neglected medical care for him. She gave him access to guns. Clegg, her son Brandon Clegg, had apparently told doctors for weeks that he wanted to kill other students and was prescribed medication, but she allegedly told him he did not have to take it. She also never told police that he had fired a gun inside the home 2 months before the shooting. Again, all these allegations are included in the affidavit. But she is not in custody. That has to go through the judicial process before she will officially be taken into custody and charged.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, there's... And I know that there's probably a lot of people associated with either the school or with other kids in the school and parents that know more about this than what we have learned up until this point. But it seemed like the truckload of charges coming after her, too.
So. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
There was a couple high-speed chases in Wayne County overnight. Actually, interestingly enough, both of them on State Road 1. One went north, one went south.
Can't take 70 at this point. I mean, if you're going to do a high speed, if you're trying to get away from the popo, you cannot take I-70.
I don't know much about the one that went north yet, but I do know about the one that went south. Uh-huh. A 24-year-old guy fled, a northern Indiana guy fled through Milton, down into Connersville, speeds hitting 95 miles an hour as he went down State Road 1, stop stick successfully deployed in Connersville, and he was taken into custody.
Yeah.
And let's end with this one. A positive note is an organization, they've reached their financial goal to convert part of Mary Scott Park in Richmond into a public access fruit orchard.
Yep. Yes.
Go ahead. Pretty cool thing here. $17,500 was the goal as of yesterday, $200 higher than that. That money will help to secure fencing and other materials needed to develop this orchard, which is, of course, right next to Dennis Intermediate School.
The event coordinator, Jay Barbie, came onto the show yesterday. He originally appeared with us first, and then, as is the case, you know, other news media pick up the story, which is fine. I mean, we're flattered by that. There's no problem with that. And Jay came in yesterday to give an update, and Jay's update was we're at not quite $12,000, and we've got until 11:45 tonight. And I went, oh boy, I thought we had until like the 17th to get the $17,000. But no, it had to be done by last night. And all this does is allow them to apply for some matching funds so that, you know, the community's not, you know, having to do all this. But with the amount of vegetables, the curriculum that's going to be developed at Dennis, and it takes a while for apple trees to grow, no doubt about it. But it's not like they're tearing down a bunch of property and then putting in a community garden. I mean, it's already public property, and so it's just a better use of it. And so I looked at maybe 9 o'clock last night, and it was about $14,000. I went, no, they're not going to hit it. And then by 11:45, they crushed it. And so congratulations to them and making that happen. I did see a $3,600 donation come in right at the deadline. I was like, okay. Well, somebody stepped up, or they were holding that back. But that's a really cool idea. So
yeah, it is, absolutely.
And you should be able to walk in there and eat an apple.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Now, we did hear about an apple orchard that lost 50,000 bushels. You know, like somebody came in and robbed them. That sounds a little suspicious to me. I don't think that that's going to be the problem with this thing. But if we can get more kids eating fruits and vegetables, that can't be bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. So nice idea. Way to go, Jay. Okay, so our question of the day, is there something around the house that's been broken for a while that you just haven't gotten around to fix? So for me, I've got this sliding screen door that goes out to the back deck, and the handle on it has been broken, I don't know, maybe 2 weeks after I moved in there 5 years ago, I think. But at least a year or two that it's been busted. And it really just takes a new, not just a screw, but I've got a like pull it off and reattach it and make sure that everything's glued together or whatever. So that's mine that it wouldn't take very long at all to fix, but I just haven't done it.
Huh.
How about you?
Well, I don't know if this counts as broken, but my living room ceiling is really tall. It's probably,
yeah.
I don't know how tall it is, but there are track lights up there.
Yeah.
And there are light bulbs out, and right. I don't have a ladder tall enough to get to it.
There you go. Yeah. Absolutely that's a problem. Now, does it bug you?
Yes.
It
makes my OCD kick in something fierce.
So that's the thing, is that you think about it, and for me, it's every time I open the door, it's like, I gotta fix that. Oh, I can't right now, though. I have to shut the door again. And then I forget about it until the next time I open the door. But if you were sitting down in that living room, and you just kind of look up and you're like, damn it. Like, I want to fix that so bad. So we just need to find somebody with a really tall ladder.
Well, I already hit up Steve Baker. He doesn't have one. It's an, yeah.
Well, Steve is so tall, just get a 6-foot ladder and throw him on top of it and fix it. Or maybe we need acrobats. We need somebody that, if you got one of those big, great rooms.
I got a better idea.
Don't say
a trampoline.
There you go. Now you're talking. Ho! Yeah! Righty tighty, lefty loosey.
That's right.
Thank you, Jeff Lane.
See ya.
It's great to have you all on board today. Let me tell you about fall break, Jeff Lane.
Yes.
We got about 20 people watching right now on fall break. We normally have 30, 35 watching in. You people on the beaches need to get with it. And stop reading books and watch Facebook.
And have me down.
And invite Jeff and I down for the beach next year.